Good morning friends. Now we can talk about the wastewater treatment in the antibiotic industry. We all know that the antibiotic industry produces resistant bacterial strains which is resistant to the biological treatment, and their end products are more complicated compared to others. The antibiotic disposable checkpoints include pharmaceutical production units, hospitals, farms and research units. When we treat the wastewater in biological treatment, we know that it is more effective and have less or no side effects, and it can be considered as complete treatment. We know the multi-millions of antibiotics are prescribed daily, which is released directly or indirectly to the water bodies, and the wastewater treatment from the wastewater treatment plants, which results in the increase of antibiotic resistant strains. When we optimize the treatment process, which help us to lower the spread of antibiotic resistance throughout the environment. The antibiotic wastewater contain complicated organic compounds, soluble or colloidal substances, high level of solid substances, biotoxic substances and non-biodegradable substances, bacteriostatic antibiotics. There are several methods available for the COD removal of the antibiotic industrial wastewater, which include hydrolytic acidification, which can reduce the COD level up to 36% to 55%, and UABS, that means upflow anaerobic sludge bed reactor, which can reduce up from 80 to 90%, and SBR, Sweken's batch reactor, which can reduce COD level of 80 to 85%, and BAC, biological activated carbon, RBC, rotating biological conductors, and AOP, advanced oxidation processes, are other methods for the COD removal of antibiotic industry. This is a picture of RBC, that means rotating biological conductor. It is efficient to remove the wastewater even at very low temperature. This is the overview of that RBC, and here the treatment include mainly three stages: rotating bio discus and single shaft spinning. In the first stages, we use dual discus. Each disc is lightweight plastic and have a 32 cm in diameter. They are spacing from they have a 2 cm spacing from the neighboring discus, which is mounted on galvanized hollow metal shaft, and 45% of the disc is submerged in the liquid. The activated sludge was distributed evenly into the three basins. The wastewater was added to the basin at the same time. The concentration ratio of the BOD5 nitrogen phosphorus sulfur in the cultivation wastewater was maintained at 100:5:1:1. The discus were rotated for one day to allow microorganisms to attach the surface of the discus. In order to satisfy the nutrient needs of the microorganisms, 2/3 of the supernatant in the basins are replaced every day. After 1 week of the operation, biofilm of 2 to 3 micrometer thick were formed. After the biofilms were fully formed, the RBC was run continuously, and the temperature varied from 10 degrees Celsius to 16 degrees Celsius. The wool experiment lasted more than 3 months. The COD removal ratio is about 70 to 80% on an average, and the pharmaceutical wastewater was decreased from its initial 8% to 6% per day. The advantages are include high concentration of the microorganisms in good living and reproductive status, the high efficiency of degrading organic compounds, high suitable for flocculation or in low rate and organic concentration. Simultaneous nitrification and denitrification accompanied by carbon removal, low water content. It's easy operation, low energy consumption and small land area. It's only need a small land area. That's all about the antibiotic industrial wastewater treatment. And thank you.